When programming, it is often necessary to establish whether something is true or false so that a computer can make decisions about what actions are appropriate to take next. For example, when deciding whether or not to provide voter registration information, the computer must first determine if it is true that the person is old enough to vote. This is something that is done using what programmers call a Boolean expression. You can think of it like a yes or no question that the computer can evaluate. It's called a Boolean because it's named after the mathematician named George Boole, who made many discoveries related to working with binary true or false values. In the voter registration example, your Boolean expression might look like this. This asks, is the value stored in the variable age equal to 18? If it is, then the statement is true. Otherwise, the statement is false. Remember, the double equals is the equality operator. It asks if two things are equal or not. If you are using a single equal sign, you are using the assignment operator to set the value of a variable, which is something else entirely. In addition to the equality operator, we can ask questions about if one value is greater than or less than another value, and these are called comparison operators. If you saw the statement 3 less than 2 in math class, you'd think something was terribly wrong, but this is still not math class. In programming, you use the comparison operators to ask the computer a question, which it can answer true or false. So with this line, the computer sees you asking, is 3 less than 2? The answer in this case is no, or false. We can use a comparison operator in our voter registration example to make the program even more accurate. Because it's not just 18-year-olds who can vote, it's anyone whose age is 18 or older. So the questions you'd want the computer to evaluate should be, is the user's age greater than or equal to 18? Like this. Now that we can express the question, we can have the computer actually do something depending on whether the answer is true or false, such as displaying the registration info if true. We'll learn more about how to do that next.